Last Sunday, 199 votes ignored the angry voices of the protesters who gathered outside the parliament to express their anger and disapproval of the tactics of the European Union-backed regime. Of course, this new rescue plan could not have come without a high cost. The Northern European taxpayers are also called to furnish another 130 billion euros, none of which will end up to the people. The money you are now asked to pay will go no further than the bags you see behind you. And if that's not enough, we should take a look to the budget cuts in the rest countries of the Eurozone. In one simple statement, this rescue plan is not a rescue plan at all. Last Sunday, the media was talking about 80,000 people in Athens and an empty square. This is not true. I was there. More than 500,000 citizens took the streets with a goal to protest against the cruel handling of the Greek government, which is acting under direction of the Troika. The members of the parliament were pressed to race through the meeting to the vote count in fear of the stock markets on the other side of the world, opening for business the next day. The Greek MPs decided to override the collective labor agreements, bringing down the minimum wage to 480 euros and even less for the youth. Further cuts applied to pensions and unemployment benefits. With this new memorandum, the official goal of the state shifts from providing the minimum necessary commodities towards its citizens in a score of international treaties to accommodate the country's debt. The brutal and unprovoked attack of the repression forces against the protesters to break them up shows one thing, just how little control we, as sovereign people, have on our government when the European Union is forcing their stay. We cannot overthrow this government because the Troika supports it. Now, according to European Union officials, we can't even have elections to appoint another in their place. At best, the government itself can decide to sack some of the ministers and replace them with technocrats. The people's voice once again wasn't heard. The government agreed to take up another loan under the strain of the European Union. Therefore, Greece continues to get monetary assistance and the taxpayers of the European Union continue to pay tax after tax, all in an effort to avoid the risk of a default. Meanwhile, Greek citizens are being terrorized with presentations of what such a default would signify for the country and why they must accept a restriction of democracy. They are also alerted that such a default might have a domino effect on the rest of the Eurozone. Should democracy then be suspended for the good of the Eurozone? The Greek people do not want another rescue plan. They do not want any money. This tactic is now known worldwide to be inefficient. In 2020, Greece's sovereign debt will be at 120% of GDP. That's exactly the same amount of debt when the country first applied to the IFSF back in 2009. During this usual circle, we will have dismantled our education and healthcare system. What people need is worldwide solidarity. I cannot stress how important this is. Our economies, our societies are connected. Back in 2009, when across Europe a turn to neoliberalism was observed, we could not have foreseen the implications this external factor would have on our society. Much has been said these past 2.5 years for Greeks and Europeans. The Greek media blames the European Union for its harshness and intolerance, and the European media paint the Greek people as tax-avoiding sluggards who want to con their way out of any deal made to them. This is one of the oldest tricks in the political book, known as divide and conquer. South Europe against North Europe, Greeks against Germans, Germans against Greeks, even Greeks against Greeks. This conflict also takes place within the Greek society, often prompted by the media. Many social classes have been targeted as more or less responsible for the crisis. Instead of continuing this dead end, we should start by simply sitting down and talking. We should finally face the problems ahead, focusing on what unites us, not to those which divide us. Our politicians, puppets in the hands of bankers, propose nothing but austerity. So let's open our minds, our eyes, our ears, our mouth, and start working. Thank you. Yeah.